Hey, horsey people! Alright, I'm gonna do this video on try to save all the sexual and rude comments. Look, removing a bean from a horse is important maintenance. Now, I think if it gets really, really bad, the horse will normally eject the bean. The bean, what I'm referring to here, so this is the penis of the horse. This is the urethra where the urine comes out, and right there's a little hole right above this. So when this gets really big, it can block the urine path, and then it will not let him completely drain. That's why it's good to check these. Now, I always get the question in the wild, how do these get rid of? Well, when horses are in the wild, they're not gelding, so they're having sex, and when they're having sex removes this. And I'm assuming that the mixture of bacteria between the female and the male does something to neutralize it or whatever. In this picture, you can see the head of the penis. This is the urethra where a horse pees. And this is a bean that has not been removed. And it's actually coming out of that hole. Normally, the bean is in this area and is hidden. And you have to push it out of the hole. This one has gotten so large, kind of like the one I removed from Ransom. And now is when it starts blocking the urine path, and that's when you can have issues. In this picture on my website, thinklikeahorse.org, I show, this is Buddy's picture here, there's a little hole right there, and that's where the bean is concealed. A lot of people just try to look at the urethra and say, okay, I don't see anything, but it's actually the hole right above it. So in this case, I was actually doing Ransom's feet, and I just got him. He wasn't my horse. And I just wanted to check. And the bean that came out was really huge. And I just want to show how I went over and kind of grabbed that in normal speed.
But a lot of times they don't check for the bean. Holy shit.
Okay, so you can tell that a large portion of this bean was already sticking out of Ransom's hole. So there's that hole in the back. You're gonna, why I'm going backwards. So all that bean was concealed inside the penis around the urethra, and it was putting pressure. So when I first went up there, before I really even did anything, you can see that the bean is already out and putting pressure on the urethra every time he goes to the bathroom. And then you can end up getting a urinary tract infection if it blocks it a lot, etc. So there's no way to remove this for the horse unless he has sex. And since most horses that we have are geldings, they don't have sex. So there's no way to remove that unless, because they're in our care, we check for this bean. Normally they're really small. You're going to see the second one I remove is much smaller. But in this one, as soon as I rolled it back, you could see the bean just totally as I'm pushing. And what a lot of people don't do, this finger in the back is actually pushing this bean forward. So my thumb is holding the skin back, and the finger in the back is pushing the bean forward. And that's what causes the bean to be ejected. I actually use my other thumb to kind of roll and help it pull out. And then it falls into my hand. And again, I'll give you a full view of this without me stopping it.
It's pretty clean, but a lot of times they don't check for the bean. Holy shit. Look at the size of that bean.
So a lot of times when I check for the bean, it's just when a horse drops normally. A horse will drop when they're relaxed, just calming, etc. In this video, I was actually just doing the horse's feet, and I was trimming his feet, and then I noticed that he dropped, and I went, you know what, since I'm filming for his feet, let me move this around and see if I can catch him with a bean. And I'll let you see the full thing
and see if I can show you all that, because I don't know if he's ever been checked for a bean.
So most bean checks are pretty,
he's like,
impromptu.
What bean? What are you talking about? We'll let him drop a little bit. His sheath looks pretty clean. But a lot of times they don't check for the bean. Holy shit. Look at the size of that bean.
So when I say the sheath is pretty clean, there's not a lot of flex and like flaking grime. Some horses just get a dirty sheath, so when they drop, you'll see all this nasty. In another video, I was out filming Buddy, and let's see, where was Buddy in this one? So that's when old Buddy and Mr. T were here. I was doing a grooming video, and Buddy suddenly dropped, and when he did, back to that.
Oh, Mr. T!
Should I go get a bean out of him real quick?
So again, impromptu, I see him drop, and I take that as an opportunity. He's calm, he's relaxed. They'll drop also before they pee sometime. It's not always a sexual thing when they drop. So when you see a horse drop, it's a good time to check for the bean. Some people will wait till a vet sedates a horse to go for the bean, because usually sedation causes them to drop, which is why if you ever go look and you're buying a horse and you see that he's dropped the whole time, it could indicate that he was drugged to make him look calm so you would buy him.
Grab a bean on how when he drops.
Okay, when I talk about a dirty sheath, you see this kind of flaking skin here? This is just like old grime and dirt that kind of flakes on there. So every time he drops and comes out, this becomes an irritant and it collects more dirt and dust. You're going to see me peel a couple of these things off. When you pull this off without putting any sheath cleaner or anything on, it pulls the skin and sometimes it will irritate the horse and the horse may kick you. You're going
to
see Buddy
get that bean.
Kind of resist me a little bit here.
So let me see if I can grab that for you.
When I pull that off. So those flakes that I'm pulling off, is basically what we call cleaning a sheath. But when you start doing that, you notice he starts retracting. If he retracts, I couldn't get to the bean. So I wanted to check for a bean real quick here. Okay, so he had a little bean and I had to push it out. And it failed while I was pulling it out. But I want you to notice the horse's resistiveness when I go back to this. So I want you to watch Buddy's resistance of his legs and his body as I'm doing this. Because this is what he's telling you. So his tail is relaxed here. His legs are relaxed and he's eating. When I pull this off, you're going to see immediate resistance and he's going to start retracting. So as he's pulling it up, I'm having to hold it down, which is causing more resistance. You're going to see his leg, you're going to see his head come back here telling me, hey, that hurts, knock it off.
Yep, he's got to be.
See the shifting and the moving of the legs? It's pretty, it's you got to watch for it. Watch this resistance, his legs. He shifts his weight. Ow, 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 he's moving. Ow, stop, quit, that hurts. So his nose comes back like, dude, what are you doing? He's warning me. Because I have a good relationship with him, he didn't kick me. But if you do this to a horse without desensitizing him, you're probably going to get kicked or bit. It's very easy for him to kick you when you're doing this. You want to usually stand in front here, so if he does kick, you don't get kicked. But when you stand in front, he can still turn around and bite you. And again, the first time you do this, it may be unusual. You may have to just try it a couple of times first just to desensitize him so he knows, and then go through with it and finish. It does fall.
Easy.
See his legs going back and forth. Hey, 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 ow, ow. He picks his leg up, warning. These are all signs that normally you would want to stop. Because I know Buddy and he's not going to kick me and we've had a relationship since he was a baby, I wasn't worried about it. But he could have very easily kicked me and he was warning me and telling me. And I saw the signs, but I ignored them. A lot of people, they don't ignore them. They just don't see the signs. They don't understand it. Okay, so in that one, it fell out. And again, there's a little hole right there that you have to roll back the skin and see it. And that's where the bean is going to be concealed. And then you have to put pressure on the back with your finger on the back to push it forward so it will fall out. And for all the people complaining, you should have gloves on. Somebody actually made a little meme about it. Yes, I'm cleaning my sheath and no, I'm not wearing gloves. Look, these are things of opportunity. By the time you go get a glove, go get cleaner, and get things, the horse is going to move. He's not going to be dropped, and then you're going to miss it. So I always say getting the bean is kind of like an act of opportunity. You have to be when the horse is relaxed and you can do it. A lot of horses won't let you do it when they're standing free, but he did it because he was eating and he knows me. When I did ransom, you'll notice he was tied up, or he would have probably ran off. So after I got the large bean on him, I went back for a second one, and there was a little one inside him that I found.
Wow. That sucker's huge. So he might have another one in there. I'm going to check for a second one.
The reason I did that, because this one was so large, I didn't know if it broke off and I left some of the piece. And I think what I removed is probably it was one large bean that was still made in there. This is produced by what they call it. I think the technical term is Smegma. And it's like bacteria and dirt and whatever. You can look it up. But it forms naturally. All geldings get them. Most people just don't remove them.
And he does. Good boy. I know. I'll leave you alone. Good boy. So the second one he had was pretty little. Can y'all see that? Compared to
the... I think I find the other one and I compare
so
them.
So that's the first one and then that's the second.
So, two large beans. And again, this feels like Play-Doh. It's putty. So it's not like hard like a rock, but it's enough to put pressure to interfere with a horse who's trying to urinate. Okay? I wanted to show this because there's a lot of confusion. I'm always getting questions on, can you show it? You went too fast. Hopefully, I went slow enough and explained it enough to where you can go out there and safely get your bean out of your horse. And, you know, little Ransom was a good boy for letting me do this, and I'm glad I found this. Again, I didn't have Ransom. This is when I first got him. He was kind of in a pasture and left alone, so I knew I should always check. You know, anytime you get a new horse or a horse that has been handled, most people do not check and clear this bean out. Okay, so that's removing the bean and sheath cleaning. We'll end that there.